It looks like a lot of information, Stephen, but in your book you talk about this as the DNA enigma. Where did this information come from? Talk about it.
Right. Well, the DNA enigma is not where does the information for building proteins reside. We now know that. It's on the DNA molecule, along the spine of the DNA molecule. It's not what the information does. We've just seen an animation of how the digital information in the DNA directs the construction of those crucial protein molecules. The big mystery associated with this discovery is the mystery of the origin of the information. Where did that information come from in the first place? And that mystery is closely associated with another mystery, which is the origin of the first life. Because if you want to build a cell, you've got to have proteins. But to build proteins, you've got to have the information in the DNA molecule. And that question has actually created an impasse in a field of study known as origin of life research. The scientists trying to explain how the first cell arose from supposedly simpler chemicals in a prebiotic soup have come up against this really difficult question, which is, how do you get from chemistry to code? How do you get a molecule chock full of digital information from blind, undirected material processes? I think that that mystery is the flip side of a positive case for intelligent design. Because what we know from experience is that information always comes from an intelligent source. Bill Gates has said that DNA is like a software program, but much more complex than any we've ever created. And we know from experience that software comes from programmers. In fact, again, whenever we see information and trace it back to its ultimate source, whether we're talking about a hieroglyphic inscription or a paragraph in a book or information embedded in a radio signal, we always come to a mind, not a material process. And so the discovery of information at the foundation of life is pointing towards a designing intelligence, toward a master programmer. And this discovery has actually also shocked some of the new atheists who have confidently proclaimed that the universe has just the properties we should expect if at bottom there's no purpose or design. Richard Dawkins, for example, just this last summer tweeted about an animation very similar to this one, and he said, animations like this knock me sideways with wonder at the miniaturized intricacy of the data processing machinery in the living cell. So far from being an expected discovery of scientific materialism or atheism, the information-bearing properties of DNA and the whole digital information processing system inside the cell is shocking to scientific materialists. It's not what they would have expected, and instead it points decisively to a designing intelligence in the history of life.